Hello everybody, hope y'all are staying safe and hope y'all are doing well. This is Dimple here again welcoming y'all back to my next tutorial on Android framework components. Today we will see one of the interesting topic, what is battery historian and how to analyze this battery historian. So this is quite a vast topic, so I'll be doing this in different parts. So in part one we'll see the introduction to what is battery historian and how it works, the architecture of that. To begin with, what is battery historian? So battery historian was a tool developed by Google in 2016. It will analyze the behavior of a phone and more precisely to review information and events related to the battery. So y'all can think like this in simpler words. Battery historian is nothing but it is an HTML view of the battery reports which is generated. So battery historian is a tool, and this tool will take bug reports as an input. It will convert this bug report into an HTML view of the battery reports. That's it. So in our device we can collect battery stats. So battery stats is nothing but the battery dumpses, right? We all know bug report contains dumpses of all the processes. So battery dumpses and battery stats will also be part of bug report. So what we do is we collect bug report from the Android device through ADB. There are different ways to collect bug report. I have already shown y'all these different ways in my previous videos. You all can go back and review those if you have not seen. So we collect the bug report from the ADB shell, bug report from our mobile device. We collect through ADB command and we input it to the web browser. So that battery historian HTML view will be generated on your computer. That's it. We collect the bug report and we give that bug report as input to your web browser, so that HTML view will be generated. Now, how to set up this battery historian tool? So there are two methods, and method one is that battery historian tool will be already available at this. So if you just go to this link, battery historian is already available. You have to browse and you have to input your bug report.zip file and you have to submit, so that report will be generated. But I do not recommend this method because it's not good to feed in your sensitive data into this browser. So what we do, we will set up our own battery historian, that is through method 2. I am telling these steps regarding Windows 10 PC. So in Windows 10, what we have to do is install Docker. Docker.exe file you'll get online, just install that and open your command prompt, and you have to run this following command: docker run port 1234 and 9999, followed by this battery stat historian. We are just installing the battery stats historian through Docker and give the port number here. Then you have to run ipconfig command. So just run this command ipconfig so that you'll get your IP address of your PC. Once you get the IP address of your PC, open the browser and give this IP address followed by the port number. So port number here we have given during the installation is 1234. So just the same port number. Example, you all can see IP address is this one followed by colon followed by the port number, which is 1234. Now you can see the battery historian. You have to browse through the bug report and you have to click on submit button. You can see the HTML report view of the battery historian. I will show you all the demo of this, how it looks. We'll move to next slide. So command to collect bug report and reset battery stats. We don't want previous battery stats information, right? We want fresh collection. So to reset the battery related information, just run this command. Connect your device to the ADB shell and run this command: ADB shell dumpses battery stats hyphen hyphen, so there is no space here, If I didn't give space, it was looking like one long line. So just to differentiate two hyphens, I have given your space. While you are running command in your ADB prompt, don't give space. Hyphen hyphen reset. So once you give this reset command, all your battery dumps information will be deleted. And once you give this ADB bug report, a new fresh log collection will be made available. Now I will show you all how this tool looks like. I have set up this on my computer. So here I have given my IP address followed by colon and my port number, which is 1234. I'll click enter. Now my battery historian is loaded. I have to browse a bug report file. So here I'll select this one and open. We'll get a submit button. I'll click on the submit button. It will take a while to generate the report. We have to wait for a few seconds. Now the report is generated. You all can see, right? So we have lots of data to analyze here. In my next video, I will show you all how to analyze this data. What is the meaning of each of these? What is the value of this battery historian? So it's a very good tool to analyze your battery consumption for your device. So I'll meet you all in my next tutorial. Until then, everyone take care. Bye.